What I can do with pin video. Okay, maybe it will record my video as well, hopefully. I don't know. Okay, let me come back briefly to the idea of differential and derivative, because this is one of central points, and it's very good to understand them. Again, like we told, in a one-dimensional case, I have a plot of function, and I staying in the point x naught, and I do linear approximation of my function. I build tangent line, and it's actually linear function. And if I make increment of x, which I call dx, increment of this linear function, I call this linear function L of x. It's what I call df. So df and dl is the same. And what can I say? So this is notation for general expression for a general linear function, some constant plus linear term. And if I want this linear function to be tangent to my original one, to f, I want the value at x naught to be the same. So I want L of x naught equal to f of x naught. And L of x naught is b. So b is f of x naught. And also, in order to be tangent, I want the slope, the derivative of L to be the same as derivative of f. So this is what I write here. L prime of x naught is f prime of x naught, and this derivative is c. And my differential increment of linear function is just c multiplied by increment of argument. And because of this correspondence, it's f prime multiplied by dx. Now I am ready to come to multi-dimensional case, which is written here. So in multi-dimensional case, linear function is a constant, scalar b, plus c transpose x minus x naught. C and x are vectors. And I want the same. I want the value at x naught to be the same as my original function. And when x is x naught, this term is zero, so the value is b. And in order to be tangent, I want partial derivatives of my linear function to be the same as partial derivative of original function. And of course, partial derivatives of my linear function is, with respect to xi, just ci. Because what is written here, it's sum ci multiplied by xi plus constant. So the derivative of linear function is ci. So I conclude that ci is equal df by dxi. But what I say is that df is increment of my linear function. And linear function has this expression. So I can write down increment of this linear function. Is if this is expression of L, it's easy to see that dl is just c transpose multiplied by dx. How much I shifted from the point x naught. And just a second. Something wrong with my Acrobat reader. Okay. And vector C, so components of vector C partial derivatives. So vector C itself, this is a vector of partial derivatives, what we will call gradient. So it's gradient transpose multiplied by dx. What is written here? So pay attention that in this derivation, we didn't refer to any classical notion of total differential. We get everything inside only from assumptions that our linear function is the best approximation of the original function. It's like tangent line. So its partial derivatives are the same as the derivatives of our original function. Okay. Any question at this point? What do you think about this new kind of explanation?
Michael, can we ask something about the lecture we saw in the video?
Let's discuss this derivative part, and then we will come to the part related to one-dimensional optimization. I want really this first part to dedicate to derivatives, and then we will discuss even a little bit if you have questions about your homework on derivatives. So again, any question regarding this?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Can you explain the last line on the left side?
This
How
one.
Did we get? Yeah, to DL.
Okay. So I have expression of L of X. Yes, which is here. Do you see my pointer?
Yeah. I see it.
And I ask if I give increment to my X. What will be increment of L? And of course, it will be C transpose multiplied by increment of X. What is written here? Okay?
Okay.
Now...
Is there... Yeah.
Yes, at this point. And then I will say that in previous line I derived that components of vector C, they are exactly partial derivatives of F. Yes, I'm with you.
So is the increment in X, is it X minus X naught?
Yes. Well, as in the picture, you see?
Yeah. Although it's now a vector.
Yes, the picture is one-dimensional, you're right, but you should think about vector dx. Yes, you're right.
Okay.
I have from my usual slides this multi-dimensional picture, yes? So this will be dx in multi-dimensional case.
Okay, so what is the new picture you try to explain to us?
So the goal of this explanation was to come up with a formula which we used in our lecture, the differential of F, and you see this is the same as differential of L, is a scalar product of gradient with dx. And pay attention, I didn't refer anything about your knowledge about total differential. We everything get inside, we only assumed that partial derivatives of linear function are the same as partial derivatives of our original function. Okay, make the same we already know a little bit more clear.
Okay. Yes, it is more clear now. It seems like L of X is the first linear approximation of F.
Yes.
In X.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, very good.